And I, for one, have had enough of simply asking ourselves whether we are willing to accept as much education as we are willing to pay for. That's an important question. But it seems to me we ought to be asking ourselves, how much education can make a difference? What outcomes do we want from public education at all levels? What does that actually cost? It's a secondary and important question, what we're willing to spend for it, but let's be real with each other about what that actually costs. And then let's start seeing what mechanisms are available to us to pay for that. What I want is a more comprehensive strategy for public education, starting before kindergarten, with early education opportunities for 3- and 4-year-olds. I want all-day kindergarten in communities where that makes sense. I want smaller class size, especially in the early grades. And I'm going to upset the kids in the room right now, but I want a longer school day. And I'm not just talking about more classroom time, although we need that too, but the enrichment opportunities and experiential learning, and exercise and music and art, the whole child approach. I think the question about the length of the school year should be on the table. Some of you I see here were involved in the campaign. I talked about this during the campaign because I believe it. Right now, we have a calendar that allows you to get out in time to plant the crops and stay out long enough to harvest. You laugh. That's where our school calendar comes from. Well, it seems to me appropriate to ask ourselves whether that makes sense in the 21st century. Why not? And how do we connect this up to the demands on all of us from the workplace and the global economy that we are becoming? More math and science required in high school. Access to community college that is free for incoming. Or if not community college, because for not everybody does it make sense, then preparation in a couple of years of an apprentice program for a trade. Because you know what? We have 125,000 people in Massachusetts looking for work right now, and 90,000 vacancies. What's that tell you? People can't find, they say, people with the skills they need to do the jobs we have. And I do want to be clear, I'm not one who believes, I know there are some who do, that education is just about preparing employees. I think education is about preparing citizens, people who are engaged, who are interested in and curious about the world around them, who are prepared to engage in constructive and productive ways in mainstream society. But I also appreciate that education is a gateway to a good job. And by the way, the stats bear that out. People who finish high school, what's the stat? $800,000 more? They earn over a lifetime than those who don't. That's on average, by the way. Which means a whole bunch of people earn a whole lot more than that. And those who don't finish high school present a disproportionate drain on social services. Everything from food stamp programs to housing subsidies to homelessness programs. Education can make a difference. Everybody says it. I've lived it. And so have some of you. So what I'm interested in is what strategies we can put in place to implement this vision. I'll put the question more bluntly. Is this the right vision in your view? And the thing I'm going to ask you is that if you do believe this is the right vision, then come and be a representative of the Readiness Project and help us make it real. Because we're going to have to build the interest in this and the commitment and support for it at the grassroots. And I am invested in that in my own time, and I'm asking those of you here who can get behind it to invest in it as well. So let me hear from you.